I be getting to the money. Everybody mad. Think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad.
What's up, Wealth Babe? Welcome back to the channel. I'm super excited because we hit that 500 subscriber mark and then some. So I do want to talk about the 500 subscriber giveaway on this channel today. And so I want you to stay tuned, watch till the end of this video because I will be talking about that giveaway. If you are new, welcome to the channel. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and also click the bell to turn on post notifications so that you don't miss out on any of the wealth building content. In today's video, I do want to talk about two types of investors. So let's go ahead and get into the video. The two types of investors that we're going to be reviewing today are the defensive investor and the enterprising investor. And while I'm reviewing these two types in depth, I do want you to sit back and think of which type investor you are. So which of these investors do you more closely align with? And the other question that I want you to sit back and think about is, what do you need to do differently, if anything at all? So if you feel like the type of investor that you are more closely aligned with is okay, then by all means, do you. So let's go ahead and first talk about the defensive investor. The defensive investor typically purchases a diversified list of stocks and bonds for their portfolio, and more often than not, they will seek expert advice. I'm gonna put expert in quotations because who's to say that the expert is truly the expert, especially when it comes to handling money. But nevertheless, this type of investor, so the defensive investor, wants to put these diversified securities within their portfolio, but they don't want to put in a lot of effort to help their wealth grow. They want to do as little as possible and in return get spectacular results. That's the premise of this type of investor strategy. So let's go ahead and talk about why the defensive investor doesn't want to put in a lot of work. So the defensive investor's mindset is, hey, I'm going to give my money away, not in the sense that I don't want it back, but give it away to the expert and let him do what he needs to. And I really don't want to have to spend my time looking up what these stocks are all about or what all of these metrics mean when it comes to stocks. And just let's say they don't want to put in a lot of effort at all. And I'm gonna say that not all of the defensive investors will typically be labeled as bad, but when we talk about the enterprising investor, you may find that the enterprising investor has more chance of growing their wealth tenfold. So don't think of these two types of investors as bad or good, rather hands-on and have hands-off approaches, which when you take your investment approach into your own hands, you could possibly grow your wealth better than anyone else could. So the defensive investor, let's go back to that. I'll say it again, the premise of the defensive investor strategy is to get spectacular results. They seek expert advice and they don't want to spend their time searching up all of these stocks and bonds and what they mean and all of these metrics. Now let's talk more about the enterprising investor. The enterprising investor, on the other hand, has a clear concept of the difference in market price of a stock and its, on the other hand, underlying value of the company overall. So I think in comparison to the defensive investor, what we can say is that the enterprising investor is a little more aggressive in their approach when it comes to understanding what the stocks and bonds are all about. So they want to know the details, the ins and the outs, the overall bigger picture as well, and will rely less on the investment advisor for their overall outcome or decision when it comes to purchasing stocks and bonds. So they're gonna put their own mind into this work because they will have some knowledge of what this is all about, or not some knowledge, but a lot of knowledge of what these stocks and bonds are all about, because they are going to be more aggressive in their approach. And typically, enterprising investors will navigate towards these four areas, which I'm about to get into, when they are this type of investor, so the enterprising investor. So the four areas that the enterprising investor will gravitate toward are, let's start with the timing formula, which is typically buying low, buying when stock prices have fallen, and selling when stock prices have risen. The second area that the enterprising investor will typically focus on is growth stocks. So they want to purchase stocks that will grow in value over time. So they'll buy companies not when they're typically new, but when they have a lower value, lower stock price, and they know that that price will grow over time. The third area that enterprising investors usually look toward are bargain issues, which really means it's kind of similar to the timing formula, but with the bargain issues, you will, as an enterprising investor, purchase the stocks at a bargain. So when they are extremely cheap, but you know that there is a greater value within that particular company. And then the fourth area, which we'll talk about, is what's the fourth area? I'm drawing a blank. Specific special events or circumstances. So one event may be such as when a company is getting ready to acquire a different company. So the enterprising investor will be in the know about all of these types of events that could be coming up. So the enterprising investor, just, they're in the weeds. They know a lot about what's going on, what the news is sharing, but they've also put in their own work to come up with their own decisions and outcomes about what they think of stocks and bonds. What I find interesting when I do research is that great investors will typically say that they are enterprising investors, which, that's why I asked you to ask yourself if you are the defensive investor or if you are the enterprising investor at the beginning of this video, because I want you to start thinking about what type of investor you are. But although the greats say that they fall into this category, what I notice is that neither is the right or wrong approach, because investing to me is like you want to grow your money. If you're in the stock market and you have a diversified portfolio, even if your hands off, you don't want to get into the weeds, you're still making a better decision than someone who isn't at all, and you still are taking the right steps to grow your money. What's even more interesting though is that what I've read is that the passive investor, so the defensive investor, is likely to make less money than the enterprising investor or the aggressive investor, which I can see why, but that isn't to say for every case of investors in each category. So do what you feel is your best approach. I say that would be my advice, because if you're investing, I'm gonna give you a clap, like a congratulations, because that's a step in the right direction. Not everyone is going to be the type of investor that wants to get all into the weeds of this stuff, because it can consume all of your time and people enjoy doing other things. So if it's not your forte, if financial, the financial sector isn't your forte, then make sure that if you are handing over your money to an advisor, that they are, you know, in your best interest. So I will leave that there and let you make the decision on your own as to what type of investor you should be. So if you've made it this far in the video, thank you. I now want to talk about the 500 subscriber giveaway. So for this giveaway, it's gonna be very easy to enter, and the entry criteria are: one, you must be a subscriber of this channel. Two, you must drop the hashtag wealthbabe in the comments, and with that comment, just let me know your favorite video on this channel, or you can let me know your favorite topic when it relates to, or when it comes to, finances or growing your wealth. Like, what types of topics are you most interested in? Be it taxes, investing, saving, budgeting, credit, you name it. Let me know in the comments, and if you meet those three criteria, then I will go ahead and enter your name in the pool of people who enter the giveaway as well. And then I'll be doing a random generation, probably in an online tool or within Excel, depending on how I'm feeling at the time. And I will be announcing the winner. I think I'm gonna do the winner announcement in the beginning of July. I think that's only 2 weeks away, so it may sound far away, but that gives 2 weeks to a lot, or you all, to, you know, enter this giveaway. Give you some time to watch this video, because a lot of people may not see it when I first release it. This is a financial channel, so I know people are not watching these videos every day. I wouldn't, because it's heavy information, and you want to be in the groove and in the mood to learn about finances when you're watching these types of videos on YouTube. So I'll give people some time to watch this video before I announce the giveaway. And lastly, I will say, as always, please remember that if you're not fully, truly, and totally committed to building wealth, then chances are you won't.